family, staff, and my fellow classmates of 2013. It's been a long journey to this point. I have to say I'm very lucky to have had supportive parents that did everything for me. My parents have always been my main lifeline for anything. If I needed money, clothes, shoes, basketball gear, it didn't matter what I asked for. I took everything for granted, and I felt I didn't work hard enough for anything in my life. And me not knowing that at any moment, you can have it all taken away from you. You see, I was just getting by, and my heart wasn't in the schoolwork. I was barely trying, and unfortunately, it took a pivotal moment in my life for me to realize that you need to be grateful for every day, and you need to put your all into everything that you do.
Amen.
My mother and father became very ill. My dad being diagnosed with throat cancer, and my mom being diagnosed with cancer also. I thought about everything bad that could come out of this situation. I never realized I could lose the most important people in my life to those very moments. I feared the worst. The feelings I had at the moments, I'll never forget. On the verge of losing it all, life got more difficult every day. Those house payments was behind, and my heart wasn't in school at all. I couldn't focus, and I wasn't on point to graduate. And everything wasn't looking good at all. I left my high school to enroll in Chancery. Emotionally drained, I didn't want to go to school anymore, and I didn't want to embrace Chancery for what it was and the message it conveyed. My first few weeks at Chancery, I was moving fast in my classes, but something was missing. I still had no sense of direction, and I didn't know what I wanted next in life had I graduated from Chancery. I finally had a few long conversations with my father, and those conversations put a fire in me that I wish I would have had before. My father said something I would never forget, and reminded me what all my hard work was for, and why I needed to get my diploma and make something better for myself. My father told me, life is what you make it. We may be down, but we aren't out. And as long as there's a way, we gonna make it.
All right.
I've lived to see you grow, and now I want to see you graduate. And after hearing that, my attitude towards Chancery changed. I started embracing Chancery for what it was. My life at Chancery changed for the better. I participated in almost everything possible. We took college tours, forever gave blood, and we placed a healthy and life with a no-shave member in the stash badge. I became a part of the Student Government Association. I was elected treasurer, and I made lifelong friends along the way. For that, I am thankful. And honestly, people want everything handed to them, and I don't blame them. It makes life easier. But if you want to have your own and feel good about it, you have to work hard for it.
All right. All right. Woo!
After life is free, and after high school, whether you have a certificate of completion, a GED, a diploma, life is no longer handed to you, nor is anything you desire. I realized that getting through what I went through made me a better person, helping me understand fully what's out there for the taking. No matter where you are in life, whatever you're working for, and whatever you're working towards, you have to put work in. Even if everything that's happening doesn't go your way, nor does it benefit you. I say that, say this. We all are going to make mistakes. It's inevitable. But how you learn from the mistakes defines you. Nobody is perfect. Remember that. If it feels like the weight of the world is on your shoulders and you feel like falling apart, from what I went through, it just means the worst is peak and the good is beginning.
All right.
We'll go through the darkness before you see the light. And if there's anything I want my fellow classmates of 2013 to take from me today is that we all endure.